Today we will be dealing with sonometer, which will help us to learn the laws of vibration of a stretched string, from where we will learn the law of length and the law of tension. So the aim of this experiment is to find the relationship between the frequency and length of a given wire for a constant tension using a sonometer. The sonometer is a device used to determine the laws of transverse vibration on stretched string. It is a hollow rectangular wooden block of more than 1 meter. A string is attached to the hook at the one end and passes over a pulley at the other end. And at the other end of the string, you can see there, it is connected to a weight hanger to provide a constant tension. This device works based on the production of stationary transverse standing waves on stretched strings. Here we are using the sonometer to find out the relationship between the frequency and the resonant length. And in the second experiment of the sonometer, we will find the relationship between the resonant length and the tension. The apparatus required: a sonometer, a set of tuning forks, a known frequency of 0.5 kg weight hanger, 0.5 kg slotted weights, a rubber pad, paper rider, bridges and wedges. So this is the sonometer, a set of tuning forks. Here we can see we are using a tuning fork of frequency 512 and then 480. This is a 0.5 kg weight hanger. These are 0.5 kg slotted weights. And this is a rubber pad. And here we have a paper rider. So this paper rider is a small piece of paper which is cut into the shape of a inverted V that has to be placed over the string of the sonometer. Then these are the bridges, or it can be also called as the wedges. So here you can see the wedges are kept at this side, and the string from one end passes over the wedges. From here it passes over to the pulley, and then at the other end it is connected to a weight hanger. The principle involving the transverse waves produced in a sonometer: if a string of length L having mass m per unit length is stretched with a tension T, the fundamental frequency of the vibration F is given by F is equal to half L the whole multiplied by the whole root of T by m. This shows the laws of transverse vibrations of a stretched string, which are the law of length, that is F is proportional to 1 by L, and the law of tension, where F is proportional to the root of T. We shall look into the procedure to find the relation between the frequency and length. Place the sonometer on the table. So attach a weight hanger at the free end of the string, which passes over a pulley. Now stretch the string and the wire by placing a suitable maximum load. Move the wooden bridges outwards so that the length of the wire between the bridges is maximum. Place a inverted V-shaped paper rider on the middle of the string. Now take a tuning fork of non-frequency. Here we take a frequency of 480 hertz. Make it vibrate by striking its prong with a rubber pad. Now touch the lower end of the handle of the vibrated tuning fork with the sonometer board. Careful observations help us to see that there is a small vibrations on the paper rider as well as the string. Decrease the length of the string by gently adjusting the bridges inwards. So at a certain length, the string vibrates and the paper rider falls, which shows the condition of resonance. Measure the distance between the two bridges. So here we can see it is 44 and it is approximately 57.3. Now bring the bridges closer and place the paper rider on the middle of the string. And hit the prongs of the tuning fork with the rubber pad and set the condition for vibrations. At a certain length, the string will again vibrate vigorously and the paper rider will fall. So now you have to increase the length of the string until the paper rider falls. So here we can see that the paper rider has fallen, so which shows that at a certain length the string had vibrated and the paper rider had fallen, showing the condition of resonance. So the previous reading can be taken as L1 and this can be taken as L2, which gives a resonant length, that is L. Keeping the tension constant, repeat the same procedure for a different frequency. Here you can see that here we use the tuning fork of frequency 512. Keep the wedges at a distance and slightly bring it closer. At the same time, take the tuning fork, hit it against the rubber pad and try to find out the exact resonant length. So note the reading here. Here you can see it is 44.8 and here it is 57.2. So the distance between the bridges can be calculated, 57.2 minus 44.8. Keep the bridges close, strike the tuning fork against the rubber pad and slightly increase the distance between the two bridges and find the resonating length. Thank you. So this is the resonating length that you can see where the rider has fallen down for the tuning fork of frequency 512. See, the reading over here is 40.3 and here it is 52.6. So the distance between the two ridges can be calculated, and this can be entered in the observation and the calculation table. For a frequency of 480 Hz, we found that when the distance between the ridges were kept closer, that means it was decreasing, the readings were between 57.3 and 44, and the difference between this reading was 13.3. Similarly, when the distance between the wedges were increased, the markings were between 57.2 and 43.9, and the difference between these readings was 13.3. And the mean of these two readings is 13.3. Taking the other tuning fork of frequency 512, when the resonating length was found, the distance between the wedges, when it was decreasing, it was between the markings of 57.2 and 44.8, and the difference between these readings was 12.4. Similarly, for the same set of the tuning fork of frequency of 512, when the distance between the wedges were increased, the markings were between 52.6 and 40.3, and the distance between these two markings were measured as 12.3. The mean of these two readings were 12.35. To find N into L, so here we can multiply 13.3 multiplied by the frequency, so that we will get it as 13.3 multiplied by 480. So the answer will be equal to 6384. Here, when we multiply N into L, we will get the answer as 6323.2. 6323.2. So we can observe that the values here, N into L, is approximately equal, which shows that the result, that is N into L, is a constant, and thus the law of length is verified.